Hi guys, welcome to beautiful Rolly Lake in beautiful BC, Canada, close to Vancouver. We just dropped some food off to our son who's camping here and took a stroll, and I started thinking, my husband and I were talking, and I started thinking about a session I had with a client the other day, and it really prompted me to think about addiction from a point of systemic point of view. Because, you know, her husband went to addiction treatment for alcoholism, and ever since he came back, they've been fighting constantly because nothing's changed other than the fact that he stopped drinking. Okay, that's changed, and that's a huge change. But they're very unhappy, and she's actually considering leaving him now after a couple of months of sobriety. Prior to that, he had 15 years of drinking and all terrible things that go with it. So why did she arrive at that point now? Because, as I said, nothing's changed. Because here's the thing with addiction. Usually, addicts don't live in vacuum, social vacuum. They usually have families, most often. They have people that love them. And when there's addiction, when there's one addict in the family system, everyone else is an addict too. Because addiction is such a strong presence, such strong, almost an entity on its own. So people with addiction are almost like possessed. You know, you can see the most beautiful, most honorable, most decent, most kindest, most intelligent people become horrible liars, manipulators, aggressive, even violent, selfish, all of that. And so when one person is in addiction, active addiction, the whole family system starts adjusting to that unconsciously. They start worrying, they start trying to protect them, which becomes controlling behavior, which then becomes like all enmeshed and intertwined, and there's whole codependency and drama constantly, and then they all become addicted to that drama. And that's what I said to my client. I said to her that instead of fighting with him and being mean to him, she said, I say the meanest things and I feel awful afterwards. I said, well, stop being mean. Just mean what you say. And that's how I titled this video. And what I mean by that is, you know, at some point, you're gonna have to treat your addiction too. You're gonna have to change. You're gonna have to stop controlling him and trying to protect him from relapsing. Because that's not gonna work. And you're setting him up to fail, and you're taking the ownership of his sobriety and recovery from him. So it feels like to him like he's doing it for you. And of course, then he will lose the motivation, and then he will relapse. And in a way, you're setting him up for that. And she was horrified when I said that. So I said, you have to be willing to let him relapse. And you have to be clear as to what that means for you. If he does, are you going to support him? Are you going to stay with him? Are you going to leave him? But you have to let him fall if he's about to fall, instead of constantly trying to protect him from falling, which comes across as terrible controlling and all the fights and yelling and screaming and all of that. So you have to communicate clearly what you want and where your boundaries are. And you need to come from your addiction-possessed mind down to your heart. You have to find love for yourself first and then for him in your heart. And you have to tell him then, kindly, compassionately, with love from your heart, what you want and what you don't want. And you need to be firm with your boundaries. But you need to communicate them and establish them in a kind and loving way. That's what I mean by mean what you say instead of being mean. And that's when changes will happen, because when you start changing the system, then the change becomes sustainable and permanent. So, heart of gold, spine of steel. That's how it works. Mean it instead of being mean.